Hey friends, Gator Mom here. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having an awesome day. Today I was not expecting to record, but I got a really fun package from Mz Wallace that I'm really excited to share with you. All right, I wasn't planning on doing any type of recording or anything today, but I got my box from Mz Wallace with a couple of items that I ordered earlier in the week, and I wasn't thinking I was gonna be getting this box like today. I thought it would be in a couple of days or even early next week, but Mz Wallace has crazy fast shipping. So I got everything today and I thought, why not? Let's go ahead, open it all up. I'm gonna share with you guys like a first impressions and show you guys what I got. And then next week I'll do a more detailed like traditional packing video for you guys. So Mz Wallace has been coming out with a bunch of new stuff like recently. I feel like they've just been kind of hammering out the new releases. It's so fun. I love everything I think that they've released recently, but I'm a big fan of their Metro line. I tend to gravitate towards everything in the Metro collections and even like the Crosby collection because it has that same like Metro quilted material. So I got a couple of small accessories and then I got one of their bags in the Metro line that I've never tried before. So I'll start with the smaller things. These are the Metro Link pouches and they are adorable. There's three different colors. There's a large, a medium, which is this size right here, and then a small. I had a hard time deciding which size I wanted to get, so I just kind of went with the medium, but I really wish I would have gotten the large and the small because they're so cute. They only come in black right now. I really hope Mz Wallace releases more of these later on, but it's just a basic little pouch that's in, of course, that quilted material. It has the nice big chunky zippers here that you're used to on all of the Mz Wallace Metro bags. And then on the back here, you have a nice sturdy little link that you can attach this to whatever you want to attach it to. So another small pouch that I got is this Metro key pouch, which I've been wanting to try for a while, but I wanted it in like a fun print or a bright color. So I've just kind of been waiting to find the one that I wanted to grab. This is so cute and really functional. It has a key ring over here on the side that you can attach to your car keys or to your bag or whatever. On the back of it here, you do have a leather Mz Wallace logo right there. And then you also have the metal Mz Wallace logo here on the front. So it's really cute. It has the leather zipper pulls here on the side. When you open up this little pouch, I did not know this when I ordered it, but you have a couple of card slots here in the middle of the bag. I think it has three or so in there. I'll pack it up for you guys next week and kind of show you more in detail, but there's three little card slots. So I think that that is such an added bonus for this little pouch here. Here's a quick little look of both of these pouches next to each other so that you guys can see for size reference. I really wish I had all of these sizes to show you because I know a lot of us were curious as to how they all kind of compare to each other, but this is what these two look next to each other. Those of you that already have this key pouch and want to see how this medium link pouch looks next to it. So the key pouch is obviously a little bit bigger than the medium one, but not by much. Another item I grabbed that I wasn't sure I wanted, but I'm so glad that I did decide to get it, is this little link cuff. And this is something new from Mz Wallace. It's designed to go around the tote straps of your Metro bags or any other bags for that matter, but it has a little plastic closure here at the top for you to kind of loop it around your straps. And then on the front here, you have three little hooks that you can attach your Metro link pouches to, or maybe your keys or anything that you have that has a clasp that you want to have easily accessible on the outside of your bag. So I'm excited to use this. This is kind of something that I really wish that the Metro bags did have, like an external like little key hook or something. So I think this is gonna be a really fun feature for the Metros. The last accessory that I grabbed, and then I'll show you the bag that I picked up, is this fuchsia lacquer Metro pouch. I am a big fan of the Metro pouches. I actually have down here, let me show you because I don't know that I've showed it here on my channel yet. I have it actually packed up in my Crosby that I've been carrying that I plan to review for you guys really soon. But this Metro pouch is the one that I have inside my Crosby right now. And this is like the traditional Metro pouch. They're soft, squishy, quilted material. I love this print so much. I wish I would have gotten more in it when they had it over the summer. I believe last I checked that this Metro pouch in this print is still on their website. I highly, highly recommend it. I think it's so fun. It's like a bright pop of yellow and blue. And I really like it on the Metro pouch. So this one I've been carrying a lot in my bags, especially when we were traveling. I have it packed up with all of my kids' stuff right now. And it holds everything really, really well. There's also a zipper pocket here on the inside that has two additional pockets inside the big pocket. So they're really, really functional. You can use them for a ton of different things. But what I was gonna say, and the whole main reason I wanted to show you guys this, is this is like the traditional Metro quilted material that we all love. This one here, this fuchsia lacquer, is not. The material is not as squishy and soft as the other. Obviously, they're totally different materials. I'm not sure that I'm a big fan. What I am a big fan of is this color. Like, holy bananas, I am obsessed with this color, but I don't know that I love this particular material. I think I like it on this pouch a lot, but I don't know that I would buy a bag in it. I don't know. I need to use it and kind of see how I really feel about it. Let me know below if you have a bag in this material. I would love to know if you like love it, or maybe you've gotten it and sent it back or what have you. I'm really on the fence with it. I think I just need to maybe see more of it and to make a real judgment as to if I like it. But the color is so pretty. I am obsessed with the color. So you have leather zipper pulls here like you do on most of the other items. A little leather logo down here at the bottom. I just realized that my nails pretty much match this little pouch perfectly. Not intentional, but inside this pouch here, you have a zipper pocket just like the one I just showed you. And inside, I'll kind of give you a better look because I had a bunch of stuff in that one, but you have two little pockets inside this pouch for you to organize it even better. So I love these pouches. I could have a million of them. I think that they are super functional. All right, last but not least, but probably the star of the show, is this Metro Drawstring Bucket Bag. I have been so curious about this bag, but I really wanted it, again, kind of in like a print or a fun color, because I've only ever seen it in black. I'm not sure if they've released it years ago or not, but the only one I've ever seen is in black. And I thought it was so cute, but I wanted something different and fun for it. So it does not disappoint, y'all. It does not. I think it's really cute. It reminds me a lot of the size-wise, the small, I would say Metro tote. I feel like it's bigger than the small Sutton, but I have not packed it up yet. It's just kind of first impressions, but I definitely feel like it's gonna hold more than the Sutton. You can carry it by the little handles here at the top of the bag, or it does come with this optional strap that you can carry it over your shoulder or crossbody. I'm not sure if I'll use the strap just because I kind of love the way that it looks without it, but of course if you need to be hands-free or carry it over your shoulder, you have that option with the little ring over here on the side of the bag. The structure of it is a lot taller than some of the pictures make it look. Like a lot of the pictures, and I've heard a lot of people refer to it as like a bowling bag type look. I imagine whenever you cinch the top of it, it can look like that, but I feel like when it's packed up, it's not going to, if that makes any sense at all. I think it's cute, kind of like the Sutton, in the respect that the Sutton has the little clasps here on the side that go down and kind of give the bag like a whole nother shape. This one does the same thing when you have it closed by the drawstring here at the top. So I think that it's gonna kind of take its shape on however you're carrying it or however you have it closed. The bottom of it, I'll kind of give you a look so you can get an idea on how big it is. See what I mean as far as it, those of you that are familiar with these Mz Wallace bags, I feel like the base of it is much wider and bigger than the Suttons. Like it's more close to the Metro bags, in my opinion. You have two zippers on this bag in the front and the back of the bag, and they go pretty much the whole width of the bag here across the top, and then they'll go down to here. So they're nice big exterior pockets for you to throw and go just whatever you need there. Same one here as it is on the back here of the bag. Then when you open it up, I'll kind of release the drawstrings here and show you the inside of the bag. Here it is, all kind of opened up without the drawstring. See how it can kind of get longer? And even when you have things in it, I think it's going to hang a lot longer instead of boxier, if that makes sense. So inside is the traditional layout of the Mz Wallace bags. I'm not sure if you can see it, but you do have that pocket back there in the back that is a zipper pocket. And then inside that pocket, just like the Metro pouches I just showed, you have the two little tiny pockets in there. So that's pretty traditional for all the Mz Wallace bags. And then over on the other side, you have your two pockets. One is just a little bit bigger than the other, kind of for like a cell phone or whatever you need. You have that kind of way to organize the inside of your bag. There's no pouch or anything like that that comes with this bag, and there's no, I'm trying to look and see if there's a key leash on the inside. There is not. So this one does not come with a small pouch, and it does not have an internal key leash of any kind. So just an FYI, but I love it. I'm really excited to pack it up and share it with you guys. When I do pack it up, I'll compare it to the small Metro tote and the small Sutton and see if I just made a liar out of myself as far as the way that they compare to one another. If you have any questions on this one or anything else that I've mentioned today, leave them below because I will be doing more in detailed videos next week. So there you have it. That is the fun that I have for you today from Mz Wallace. I hope that this video was helpful. I know a lot of us were anxious to kind of see some of these in person. So I hope you guys have a good day, and I will talk to you on my next video.